So I would say we had some pretty big news this week in regards to Burn the Witch, seeing as the original volume length was going to be one volume or two volumes, depending on how they were going to do it, and four chapters. It seems that for the first time in Shonen Jump magazine history, as far as I can recall, if we're not counting Togashi and his consistent hiatuses, we're getting a season two of Burn the Witch. So let's discuss that, shall we? Now, I had done a video about this prior, except I didn't release it, and that was because I didn't want to potentially raise hopes up of people, and I kind of wanted some more evidence. And since as Kubo's comment of the week, last chapter for chapter 3, was a little bit, you could interpret it however which way you wanted to, I'll show that on screen right now. Kubo basically says that he's been swamped with work for the graphic novel, which graphic novel is the English term for manga, essentially. So that's just Viz changing the translation to make it more westernized. If you haven't checked out the chapter 3 of Burn the Witch that I did the review, please go check that out, because I actually said that it seems to me that Burn the Witch was going to be ending seamlessly on a kind of open-ended form, which if Kubo wanted to revisit it, or if Shueisha wanted to do more with it, it was good in that sense too, because obviously only good for business, which I think Kubo was very smart with. But also on the other end as well, is that like four chapters isn't really enough. And from reading the chapter 4 spoilers and seeing how it plays out by interpretation, it was probably the best decision Kubo could make. And to be honest, I think Kubo knew deep down that this was going to go further than he originally intended to. But hey, you know, he did this in his free time and as a hobby. So let's get down to what we actually know, shall we? So yes, in the weekly Shonen Jump magazine leaks, we have obviously confirmed that there is going to be a season 2. Volume 1 will have, 260 pages for Volume 1, which is a lot. So I concluded that that would include the one-shot, which is 62. Chapter 1, which is 58 or 57. Chapter 2, which is 38. And then Chapter 3, which is 32. And then this one, which is 55. If we conclude those all together, that's 145 pages. And I assume the 15 extra pages are going to be illustrations for the other characters, stuff from that you probably would have got from the Bleach Jet art book as well. Just 15 pages of information and informative stuff, maybe recaps and whatnot, and some like character graphs and stuff like that, pretty much. Now, if Kubo said in this comment of the week on chapter 3 that he was swamped with a graphic novel, well, he did the manuscript a year ago, and he's saying he's swamped. This is a guy that for doing weekly manga, was drawing color pages, was writing new manuscripts, was doing quality controlling and checking and proofreading, or X, Y, and Z. You really think, to me, doing some color pages, when a manuscript was done a year ago, doing some color pages and maybe some like cover art for the volume was really gonna get Kubo swamped? No, straight away it screamed to me that he's doing a continuation of the series, which I'm glad that actually Shueisha, now we don't know when season 2 is going to start. This is very different and very new, but as I said in past streams before, that, you know, the chances that we're going to get 2 movies and 6 OVAs and then possibly a TV series later on, it seems like that is still coming into fruition. So it seems to me that the reception from the Japanese audience from Weekly Shonen Jump already solidified itself within the second stage of its manga run. So if Kubo is writing this comment of the week on the third chapter, that means that chapter 1 and chapter 2 already received a mass amount of support, that Nakano picked up that phone and said, "Hey Kubo, you wanna come back, bro? You wanna come back?" I think they always had that discussion that if it does well, could he continue? And I think Kubo got himself a really good deal in terms of like possibly a contract here. If Shueisha can keep Kubo on a seasonal basis and keep going at Kubo's own pace so he doesn't get burnt out or doesn't get frustrated with this work, I think that this is probably the best contract for Kubo to have in regards of like, now we're not going to count Togashi. Togashi is that special case where he's had, well, Togashi can make 10 chapters and then just leave it be and not come back for like 2 years if he wants to, because it's Togashi. And every volume that he sells is the top seller of that week or that month, you know, going by like 650,000 in its first week, because that's Hunter x Hunter for you. And that's just how good it is. And that passes One Piece. So, you know, they give him that leeway because he brings results. And I think Kubo, the same way, brings results as well. So what does that mean for Kubo, for the Bleach anime, and for potential works in the future? Well, I want to make that a separate video, because at the moment I want to focus on Burn the Witch for now. So if you guys are really interested about hearing about the studio, about hearing about Kubo and about Bleach and potentials of what we can get later on down the road, then please hit that like button and comment in the comment section down below, because I want these videos to do well. So I will leave it off with that. Are you guys excited for Burn the Witch Season 2? I know many of you are waiting for the movie and waiting for the animation, but hey, it looks like you're gonna have to read the manga now if you wanna get up to date with a lot of stuff after the movie. And I think that's really good, that after the movie, people are gonna want more. So that's great. I think Nakano really hit the nail on the head. So I will update you when the announcement for Season 2 comes out. And some of the rough sketches that I've seen, it seems like we're not going to get any of Sakka, the guy, was it the guy? Yeah, the guy that was like not in the horns, like the mysterious character that wasn't there. Seems like we're going to get him in Season 2 of Burn the Witch, so that's going to be interesting. And I really hope at some point, you know, a Bleach character, whenever in this series, does make a cameo. I think it is really important for one of them to make a cameo. So, and I think Kisuke is the one to do it, to be honest with you, if not Ichigo's kids or Ichigo. But with that being said, yeah, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.